Hi, welcome to CIL 621, Week 2. This is going to be a very brief overview of the syllabus. Make sure that we understand what's going on in the course. We'll talk about reading, assessment experience overview, checklist and resources, how to use the rubric, why you would want to send out a parent letter, and other optional assessment experiences. I am in the modules, and I am looking at the fall 2018 syllabus. I'm going to scroll down and first of all hit very quickly on the required book is the Flint and Cooter, from which you will draw all of your assessments except for one. And there are also some additional assessments that you can use in resources that we'll talk about a little bit later. The required reading is essential in this course, and I expect you to refer back to the course readings in everything you do, the discussions, the assessment experience write-ups, the reflection at the end in the student portfolio, and also the final exam. So please take careful notes and show me how you're going to use this information to make decisions about assessment, how you use data to inform your instruction. I'm going to scroll down now to the assignments and the assessment experiences. Under point number 3, we have 4 assessments. And I know that I just realized there are a few sixes in here. That's we used to do 6 assessments, but I've taken it down to 4 because I want you to pay very close attention to everything that you do in these assessment experiences. The first part is the student data, and that is where over here in the schedule that I have on the side, the optional AE inventory comes in. An AE inventory or an assessment inventory will help you learn a little bit more about your student, their lived literacy experiences, the things that they're interested in, but also how they feel about literacy, reading and writing in general. Okay, so how do we know which assessments to do? Of course, that's located in the calendar, but under modules, you will also notice that there is an AE checklist. The checklist will tell you what is due each week, and of course, I will go over that as well. The first one is a choice of different selections. These are all located in the resources, which I will talk about in just a moment. Anything that says required means that you will be applying, for example, an IRI assessment and no exceptions. The choice assessment is important not because you make a choice, which we've done from a very select list. You can use any of these or you can choose something else. Choice also means that you are making decisions based on the 2 prior assessment experiences and 3 if you did the interest inventory. So when you're making choices, you are making informed choices based on your knowledge and experience. The last one, of course, is required. An informal writing assessment will be administered whether you're elementary or secondary. Now, to find the additional assessment resources and also videos that show you how to do the assessments with your students, I'm going to go back to modules and scroll down. After the modules appear, the assessment experience resources will also always be at the very end. So here we have the interest inventory resources that you can choose to administer to your student. You will also see we have concept of print and so on and so forth. So these are all different kinds of assessments that you can use in the course, of course, but also in your classroom. Anything that says, I'm going to scroll down here to the bottom, that there is a student video is going to be somebody administering one of these assessments to a student. So sample videos will give you an idea of what an assessment experience should look like, what kinds of questions, if any, you should be asking the students, how you guide them through taking the assessment and in order to get the best possible data. So those are your resources and the checklist, which will be really important to use. Don't forget that the schedule of the due dates is located under the Canvas syllabus, which is a little different from our official course syllabus, and this will give you the due dates. For the assessment experiences, you must administer an assessment well before these due dates so that you have time to do the write-up adequately. Lastly, I'm going to be sending out a parent letter template shortly in the next couple of days.